So exciting to do something cultural together.
Matt Groening, what's he doing in a museum? He can barely draw.
No!
Oh, no! I'm being erased!
Move it, bub. We got an installation to installate.
Are you ready? Are you ready? For the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
You can get it walking. You can get it talking. You can get it working a plow. Matter of fact, I got it now. A hard-earned thirst needs a big cold beer. And the best cold beer is Vic. Victoria Bitter.
It's so hard to have a gay time on your own. It could be that grey chalk and biscuit coating.
So hard to have a gay time on your own.
It could be that smooth toffee ice cream in the centre. Or that whole delicious golden gay time taste.
So hard to have a gay time on your own.
Street's golden gay time. Now about...
I'm Danny, and I'm here to call out all you crack-pack bitches. You think I don't see you there? I'm the OG of this shit. But you come after the king, you better come correct. I'm Danny, motherfucker. Who are you? Crack pack. You smoke crack. You better watch your back.
Welcome, Rob Witt. There you are. He's snuck it. What's with all this highlighting all the compliments to you?
I'm just building back up my ego after you destroyed it last week, Michael. You know, and once the show anymore.
I thought let's bounce it back a little bit. You know, ping pong, tennis, bit of give and take, yin and yang. That song is ruined by Bancroft in Plum Smugglers. I like that, Plum Smugglers. Ooh, me plums. How are you, Rob? How are you feeling? Doing well?
Good, man. I think you should shout out the chat because these are the real people. The real people that are here for the art, the comics. They're here.
Well, thank you for letting me know how to do my stream.
Good.
You know, I'm getting close to 1,000 streams.
Crazy.
Isn't that crazy? Yeah, no, I do want to shout you all out because we're going to have another intimate and ugly stream tonight, although it's actually going to be pretty beautiful. because judging off what Rob has given us in the thumbnail, it's going to be, we're going to have some really nice art to check out tonight. But I do understand, as is the norm, it's the new norm these days. We are really up against it in terms of options out there. So thank you. Thank you very much for being here. Rob is the man of the people, says Henry Bemis. First and foremost, can I just shout out Sumo Thori? Why doesn't it show up? Hang on. I got to go. Do I do it here? Here we go. Sumo Thori and Jake Martin both gifting 5 memberships before the show even starts. What do I do for these two? I'm going to give them one of these.
You little ripper!
And one of these.
Absolute mad lad!
Hope your ears are okay after that. Oh, and here in the Steadfast, 3-month member says, Hail Bancroft and Rob, hope both you gents are doing well. I'm doing fine. Now, I had a bit of an earache this week, but it seems to be clearing up. Camel put me onto these new bone conduction earphones if I need them. He says, you won't ever get an earache ever again. So that's just the cost the price you pay when you stream, I think.
What are you doing with your headphones to give you an earache? That would be my question.
Jam them in my ear. I have dainty ears.
Mm.
They're not giant gaping ear holes like you have, Rob. Mm. Sequential Treasures, first among all tonight. Thank you so much, Sequential Treasures, for sliding in, getting it done before everyone else.
Can I share this while you're talking? Because this is what the plan was.
Okay, yeah, do it. Go for it. So you're just going to play that?
Yeah. Well, you can,
While I say hello. All right. So there's something playing in the background. Okay. I like it. Bretsky the Great. Hi. How are you going? Jeff Styler. Corey Barton in the house. There might be some Barton art tonight, I think. I'm guessing. I don't know, actually. Dale A is here. Rick Saylor. Hail Michael Deacher. Who else? Dojo Kuhn is here. Simply Green. All the best people like Jeremy Burtz. Is that the Goblin Queen on the thumbnail? We don't know.
No idea.
No idea. Sumo says bone conductors. Okay. Gary G in the house. He's dubbing this the Rob Share. I don't know if that's gonna take. That's gonna last. Jake is here as well. We Appa mentioned. Thank you again for gifting those memberships. Very generous of you, Jake and Sumo. Who else do I spy in the house here? Whose art are we looking at here? Do you know?
Well, I'd have to shrink it down, but we'll have a look in a minute. Pretty amazing, though. Like, really, like top level.
I love pencils. Pencils might be one of my favorite forms of art. Hail Mr. Mo Biggs, the Golden Wrench, right here in the chat, throwing up those VBs. We've got Atheline here. We have, did I say Cranberry Langers?
The hell,
say
Snuggie? Gotblade.
Hmm?
Snuggie's like Kick Rob. What the hell, bro?
Hey, look, not everyone can be a fan, all right? I told you. I got a lot of criticism of your of your stream. It was probably all Snuggies. Just sent me a wall of DMs. Mike TV Dub, I know. For straight, man, it is everyone's society. It's like that. Often no one will be streaming and I'll watch something else. And then, you know, it's like when it rains, it pours. We can't do anything about it. This is what it is. This is my lunch breaks. That's what I do. Wayne is here. All right, we're just going to have to kick on with the show. Oh, there's Snuggie. Look at him. He's dabbing up in the house, giving it to Rob, just the way we like it. So if you're not aware, these are the Rob files, not those other files. This is full of goodness, hopefully. And I'm guessing a few ladies. This is my guess.
Oh, there's a whole section, Bancroft. I'm taking you on a journey tonight.
Oh, you've got a story. Yes, good. Mm-hmm. Excellent.
Mm-hmm. I've got a section that you'll hate as well, but you know, you're forced to do it because I've said so.
As long as there's no giant cupcake nipples.
Oh,
we should be fine. Oh, okay, there is. Okay. The Rob Files. Here we go again on an adventure. Let's all see where Rob Arnold is going to take us over the next hour. I'm excited. All right. This is like,
let's kick it off with some journey. Draughtism. What do you think, Mike?
You've been studying. You've been learning. I love it.
Well, I heard you say it last week, and, you know, I can remember one thing, so that's good. Here we go. Bam. This is by Jose Ladron.
Holy crap.
Isn't that amazing?
All right. We're going to have to do a little bit of this because I need to... Do we have any Zoom powers, or is that... I don't know what Facebook is capable of. Holy cow. Is that a comic or just a piece of art?
I have no idea, but it is amazing.
I want to read the hell out of that comic. That's the kind of stuff I love. These sci-fi friggin' backgrounds.
Yeah.
What's his name?
Jose Ladron.
All right, Jose, you are officially inducted into the... we got to come up with a cool acronym. Drawtists Association. Drawtists. We have cock. We need... dick. I can't think of anything at the moment. I'll think of it. Snuggy says this looks cool. The deep research Rob does is incredible.
Just get Mo to think of something, Bancroft. He's smarter than you. He'll be able to do it.
Who? Yeah, Mo. Mo'll be able to think of something.
Yeah.
I don't know why I would have thought to come up.
This is amazing. Like, if you ever had an artist do a piece of art for you like this, this would be like, this is the dream.
Hmm. The reason I ask is it's a comic because there's a lot of storytelling going on here. I mean, what is that guy doing? He's dressed kind of like Indiana Jones. There's cyborgs around. There's levels there. That's level 42. Reminds me of Silo a little bit. That's definitely the Inkal. I have not... the Inkal? I haven't actually read that.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm keeping it off with that. Homage to the Inkal. Not sure.
The Drawtist Institute for Comics, or the Drawtist International Comics.
I told you he'd nail it.
Yeah, that works. That works.
Okay. Let's see what we've got up next. All right. Here we go. This is... you said you liked pencils, Mike. You said you liked pencils.
Hold on. I got to shout out the Rumble Gang. I've been completely ignoring them. I apologize. Shout out to the Rumble Gang. No wonder that they get on me. We got 6-7 watching over there. Tacitus is over there. Popeezy. He says it's lots of detail and really nice. I gotta keep my eye on that, on the Rumblers.
Just some sketches here from Steve Sketches.
Steve Sketches.
What do you think, man? Pretty good.
Reminds me a little bit of that other guy you shared.
Does those,
you know, just white background sketch stuff. Yeah, that one's really cool.
Let me go full on this.
Like, definitely, that big monster there definitely looks like that other one, that other guy that we've been sharing.
Dude can definitely draw. Not cheap, though. He's got his rates up, so you can go check it out. But he's not cheap. But, I mean, the quality is outstanding.
Well, yeah, but I wonder what you're gonna, what you would use this for, you know?
Yeah.
Other than just have a really cool, high quality sketch.
Well, I think he does like D&D character designs. So you've got a D&D character, you can make it come to life with his art.
Yeah, it'd be cool for like a trading card or something like that.
Yeah, I think he's got some. Like, there's a full render. I mean, yeah, there you go. There's the prices there. Not cheap, but
anyone out there with a lazy $800?
That's really nice, though, man.
And then you'll post it on Twitter, and everyone will say, "I hate AI art."
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
Who is it? Ask Dojo.
It's Steve Sketches. It's right here, Dojo.
Steve Sketches.
Okay. Yeah, Steve Sketches. All right, next. We have... I just found this guy. He's like, seems like a pretty damn good artist. Will Conrad Art, doing military scenes.
Reminds me a little bit of old Aaron Alfechi when you first found him.
Yeah, you reckon?
A little bit, yeah. Like the thick shot. I think Aaron's better, but you know, the deep shadows and everything, the military stuff.
Yeah, I mean, this guy would be great if you're looking for a comic book artist. If you you know, if he's available. I don't know his state of availability, but yeah, really quality stuff, I think.
He's drawing on an Apple iPad. I know that because he's got that $200 pen.
Oh.
Which is that the one charge.
Is that the one you can't afford?
No, I got it. I got it. I had to get a thing to stick around it to make it thicker. I couldn't hold such a thin pen.
Yeah.
My hands aren't wet used to it, you know?
Corey says, looks all right. Not that impressed. Moving on. This is Yago Williams. I just thought this was a cool piece. Pencil.
Are you excited obviously. For this movie?
No. No, I'm not. I'm not excited for any of the movies anymore, man.
Me either. And like, nothing. I feel nothing.
I like Ryan Reynolds, but I feel like you can only handle him every couple of years. You know, like he's the same in every single movie he's in now. And it's just like, you know, sarcastic, dickhead, comedian, funny kind of things. It's not me. What do you think? This is
rad. The only criticism I would have, who's this?
Yago Williams.
Yago? Is, I think the proportions are off on Deadpool. He's got really short legs. I think he did that to fit him in the frame.
Yeah, and the same with Wolverine's claws. I mean, they look really short, even with perspective.
Corey says, interesting pose and expression on the female character. Yeah, she's probably the best.
Wolverine face is a bit weird though. Now that you mentioned it, oh no, it's all right.
She's yelling. Yeah, she's probably the best in it, but he's pretty good.
Pretty good. Okay, moving on. Next, this was a piece by Luis Thomas.
What's going on in that guy's head? Yeah. My ass. No cupcake nipples.
Oh my god, I didn't notice that.
What is that? Yes.
I don't know.
What character is that?
Captain Knobhead.
Captain Knobhead.
It's funny. He's got it looks like a snake type thing on his chest here.
I thought that was a lightning bolt.
Yeah, but it's got a little head on it. It's got a little head on it, and so does he.
Drawers repeat. So you find these artists in your journey out there to just sort of kind of try to find cool new artists who might be available for work.
Yeah, man. I love it. I love you don't understand. I love art. I love seeing it. I just it's something I always wanted to do and I gave up on it way too young.
Sumo reckons it's the Reservoir Tip. He might be Condom Man.
You could be
Dinger Man.
Captain Condom. guys, this is an amazing piece of art, and we're getting distracted by the fact he's got a condom on his head.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It could be a commission. They're like, hey, I need you to draw my characters. And they're like, okay. Is that a paddle? What is that?
I don't know. A shovel?
Hmm.
Shovel Man and Condom Head.
Mo says Rod is going to make Bancroft install one of those handy grips on the top of his head after saying this. No, I will not.
Gross.
Oh, that's a good name. The Trojan.
He could and use a bit more bulge here, Bancroft, I think.
Yeah, it's a bit white. That's a bit golden age. That's how you used to do it back in the day. A
bit nappy like, really.
They call it a diaper in the States. That does look like Two-Face, but yeah, like with long hair.
Rock Two-Face.
Younger rocker when he's rocking days.
I don't know. It doesn't look like a spear to me. It looks like a shovel. Yeah,
it's not a spear. It's got things on it. I don't know what it is, but
still. What would you rate this piece, Bancroft?
Competent. I would be interested in seeing it kind of inked and stuff. So, some things I'm not really figured out.
Mo says he's part of the Magnum Force.
What's a Magnum Force?
Oh, mate. Sorry, Mo. Bancroft doesn't get jokes.
What? What is what? It went over my head.
This is Daniel's. Alvaro Martinez Bueno.
Of course it is. No one named no one of the name as normal as Daniel Scott does art like this. He's on a mission to conquer Uranus. Oh, it's a brand. Okay, sorry. Yes.
What do you think of this Harry? Piece?
Yeah, I dig it. I really dig it. That almost reminds me of Phil Diaz's character, you know, with the mask thing.
Yeah. What is this, Copics? Is this Copics, you think?
No, I would say that's painted. Mm. I don't think that's Copic. I think it's a little loosey-goosey. The one on the right down the bottom looks like a dwarf. He doesn't look like a kid compared to the others. The others are amazing. Like, it is not easy to draw kids. But that's
you've killed enough of them in your book.
That's why I killed them all. maybe watercolor, maybe ink wash. I'm not sure. Yeah, it looks like it's a. He probably did pen for the line art and then ink washed it or something.
Like, it's amazing, but I prefer pencils like than this kind of style. But that's just me personally. I don't know.
Yeah, it's, you know, this is what they do on Merry Boys. Which everyone loves.
All right, next. This is from Valerio Gian Giordano. Oh my god, what a name!
I think we know Valerio. I think we know him. We've seen him before. Well, that's cool.
Yeah. I mean, that's.
I wonder if that's a photo bash.
Sure.
I don't know. Those guys, the soldiers, they look a little like it's a photo. I've got, and again, no problem. I don't care about photo bashing. Just wondering, like those textures and stuff on the beast, maybe. I don't know, but yeah, that's cool, huh?
It's really cool. I mean the beast,
like horror sci-fi.
It's hard to believe that this beast man would ever get caught, though. You know, like he's just sick.
Maybe he has a weakness.
Yeah. Ladies. All right. Next.
Kevin Beamer says, I'm only here to listen to Australians pronounce strange foreign names.
Yeah.
John says, I think I've heard of Valerio before. He had to get a swab test in. What, John? No, that's not what happened. Bancroft has such a discerning eye for photo bashes when Rob is picking the art, but picks full on AI weavery when it's his week. That is true. I've been caught on many an occasion. Camel is here. He says, the best part of tonight's show will be when Mike forgets my art. This is all Rob, Camel. You're going to have to come back next week for the normal scheduled programming. This is the Rob files.
So this is by Carlos Lopez. It's Turtles, obviously. Not bad. What do you think, Mike? What do you think?
Scroll up. I like the turtles. The pants are a little MC Hammer.
Hammer pants. Yeah. Don't you think? Yeah, and
there's something in the turtle pants.
It's an interesting choice of angle as well. You know,
yeah, because that's like a lot of pant.
It's a lot of crotch shot.
A lot of real estate.
I better get Camel's piece, or I'll never hear the end of it.
Because look, you can see, you know. Go down. The fabric is stretching right at the knee, which means that's not a mistake. That's those pants where the groin goes all the way down to the knee. That's MC Hammer pant action. That's a turtle who needs some Magnum, says Jack Mark. It's inspired by Chris Cross. Amber Lang is asking the eternal question, who is this Angela Curry bloke? Yeah, we know Tay Tay, but we don't know this Angela Curry.
This is this piece by a certain Mr. Moon.
By Mr. Moon, who is doing commissions. And this is, it's good that we're showing it this week because, you know, last week everyone was talking about Rogue Butt.
Yeah.
And they were sharing that amazing piece of art that someone had done. and it was just going everywhere. And Camel,
that's not Mark Brooks's piece, is it?
No, someone else.
Okay, good.
And Camel says, "No, Rob, you do you. It's what you're best at." Camel got in on the action and did this commission piece of Boots and Heels, and we can see Heels down there in the very similar pose.
It's
Rogue.
She's got a massive butt too. Look
at that. Big booty action. It's funny. It's right at the bottom of the composition, but your eye is drawn directly to it.
It's strange. It's like the first thing you see.
Angela, was it the same for you, being that you're female? Your eyes are just drawn right to those back melons? I'd be interested to find out.
He says we can see it colored on his Twitter.
Can.
Okay. I don't know where I was. Was it here? No. I was there. Okay.
You're at Hammer Pant Turtles.
Fabio Simial. Oh, this is a Reaper Destroyer piece.
Hold on. Let me find Camel's colored piece.
Oh, I mean, this is beautiful. Look at
that. Don't get ahead of yourself, Rob. Hold on a second.
Dojo Kun says back melons.
Back melons. Yes.
I like it.
I've never heard them called back melons before. Well, it's because they just made it up. These new commissions, Boots and Heels, the other is for Snuggy, one was for Crazy Mad. So the Crazy Mad got this one, I think. No.
Nice.
Did I read that right? I really love how Camel just does his own thing with the colors and everything. Very nice.
You can't
and
help
this but the other one.
What's he gonna do that to Heels that's laying on the ground? You can't help but think that, you know.
Wonder what's in store.
Yeah.
Looks bet, like she kind of wants it.
I bet he wishes he wasn't a robot.
If you come across a lady in that position, usually things are happening, you know.
Or she Look, doesn't he's got, know.
He's got Ella. He's got Ella from Fractured Mind in here as well.
Yeah. You can tell it's not Ella because she's got boobs, Mike.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not Ella. It's Camel's own character. Jake would miss that signal. All right, let's get back to the Rob files.
So this is Fabio Simial. This is Reaper Destroyer. This is incredible, man. This is like... I'll show it here first, and then we'll zoom in on it. But this is
shout out to Joe, who lost his father last week.
Oh wow, really?
Yeah, it was really
that
sad.
Sucks. That's horrible. What do you think of this piece, Mike? This is sick.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Reaper Destroyer brings all the artists to the yard. So many people want to draw this character.
Yeah,
because he's like, he's like all of the cool stuff from all the characters from the 90s in one.
Yeah. That's really cool. He's got other work too. He's done lots of work for different people. Oh, wow. I haven't seen this. That is sick, dude. Have you seen this piece?
No. Why would I have seen it?
Wow.
Where would I have seen it?
I don't know.
I'm not
that
on the Facebook.
Sick, dude. Well, this is Twitter.
What's this guy's name?
Fabio Simial.
Maybe I actually, I have seen this. I remember those nipple coverings. I think I did like this somewhere. And I remembered those nipple coverings.
Everyone in chat, just hear what Mike said. He remembers this piece of art purely because the nipples are covered.
The armor areolas. everyone's making fun of the fact that I said shout out. It wasn't appropriate to call to light what happened with Joe's father. And Mo's making fun of me. I just say things, all right?
Big ups what I mean. To my boy Dave. He just got paralyzed.
I didn't realize shout out was like meant like that, but okay. I just meant it was like.
Yeah, this guy's really, really good. This is a fan art piece, man. Like, this isn't commissioned. This is fan art piece. So that is bonkers.
Who is this dude? Is he famous?
I like that. I mean, he's got skills, dude. Skills to pay the bills.
Cranberry Langer's doing his best Buffalo Bill. I like the skin and the coloring.
Okay, this lotion on the skin. This section I like to call Mike rates these colorists out of 10, okay. Even if he doesn't want to. Okay, first up, we have this piece.
And into a game.
Marcos Martins. I think that might be the same colorist that Fowler used on one of his books, but I'm not 100% sure. What do you think, Mike? I'll go full screen for you.
It looks like Wolf, but not Batsy. I don't know what this is from. Colors, I would rate this a... I can't see anything wrong with this. This is a 9, a 10.
Pretty good.
I can't foul anything. I mean, it all looks, using all the different techniques, it's balanced. I might have used something a bit more like a bright green or a purple or something, or red for those things. But if that's the colors that they are, then that's the colors they are.
Yeah, colors Dixie Rose, Prospectors, and Godslap. Yeah, there you go.
Clearly Godslap, a professional.
Godslap is that the book from that really popular YouTuber, Mike, that Penguins, whatever his name is.
He's got a book out right now. Is that the guy?
I don't know. Or is that yes?
Dog something. I don't know.
Yeah, I think this is pretty cool. I like the background. It's pushed really far back. Your eyes are drawn to the right.
The only thing that's throwing me off a little is the color of her dress. But if that's the color of her dress, then that's just what it is. You know, if I were able to choose, I would choose probably red. But that's just me.
But would red take away from the blood that's in his mouth?
No, I think it would complement it. I think they would go together.
All right, so 9 out of 10, not bad. All right, let's move on to this piece here. This is from Leah Kemp. I tried to hire her back in the day. What do you think, Mike?
Stunning. I think it's beautiful. I love red as a highlight. I just actually got to use red in Painted Death for the first time ever as a highlight, and I'm so happy I was able to fit it in there.
Was it the murder red of more kids?
No, it wasn't. It was the introduction of the bad guy, so it worked red and blue with the Le Deschamel, Zoe Deschanel. Red and blue, beautiful. I mean, I have nothing to fault this. I don't want to critique anyone who's clearly way better than me.
But that's the game, Mike. That's the game. Yeah.
No, this is a 9 or a 10 again.
I think with like colors, like the most important thing for me is the mood and the feeling you get from it rather than like the technical aspects. And I think this mood set here is just fucking, you're right in it. It's awesome.
Green. Says finally getting to the bad guy in book 2. No, I'm not Rob. I introduced my bad guy in the first 20 odd pages.
What the fuck?
I know that's your hero. Sorry, not your bad guy. I apologize, Rob. I didn't mean to say that.
Get it right. Okay. Next one. This is just a cool cover I came across. These pencils by Marcus Vinicius.
I didn't even see pencils in this. I would love to see the progression of this because that looks painted to me. Some people can do that though. They take pencils or inks and the way they color it, it looks like it was painted.
Yeah.
And they just use the pencils as sort of a guide, which is one way to do it. But yeah.
I kind of feel like a good colorist can take any sort of work and elevate it. I don't know what point of that was. It is Goblin Queen, by the way, whoever asked. It is Goblin Queen.
There you go. What's Goblin Queen from?
I don't know. You should watch Goblin Slayer, it's though, like Mike. It's
Lady
great.
Death or something.
All right. This piece here, this is from Ed Lavely. Lavely? Or Black Annie by the Indomitable Ermitus Blanco. So it's one of those two. What do you think, Mike, of this piece?
I love that as well. That's a 10. I love it. It looks a little bit like Elizabeth Brightwise.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Jesus. Every single week.
That like the foreground in green with the blue and then the pinky purple at the top. I said nothing wrong with this at all. That's fantastic. And I like that it's flat, but you know, there's also shadow and stuff on it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mo. Earning his work for the month. He's popping out all these links.
His work for the year, I'd say.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a great piece, dude. You'd be really happy if you got that back.
Poplade wants you to zoom in on her face.
Sure.
And enhance. Yeah. Inspect the goods. Yeah. There's nothing wrong about this. I even like that it's kind of roughly done. You know, it's not perfect. There's things going outside the lines, and I think it adds a bit of charm.
Yeah, let's zoom in on this one too.
Cranberry Lang is not a fan of washing out the bunch of people with the same color, though. But it looks great. I like that. I don't do that myself, but I do like it. I do appreciate it.
That's sick, isn't it? Like, that looks fucking wicked.
Yeah. It's beautiful.
I might have to reach
out. Womanly, too.
Yeah, I mean,
they were showing Yara art off earlier, and I don't know, for some reason, I don't know, people seem to be drawing her really manly now. I don't know.
But that's what you want.
Yeah, exactly. You know, these characters, like ones like this, you know, go feminine, ultra.
Yeah, feminine. I mean, who would imagine that people want women to look like women? I mean,
you can still be scary and strong or whatever and be hot and female. Like, it's,
yeah.
35 minutes in before the Elizabeth Brightwiser reference.
We've got about three more of Michael Rate the Colorist pieces. So here we go. This is,
he's loving this.
I think this is a fan piece over Rob Willis. Okay. So Mike, out of 10.
So fan colors over, yes, Rob Willis.
Yeah. Hit it with a bit of zoom.
I like it.
You got Juggernaut and Spider-Man, obviously. Go back to the smaller size. What do you think?
I like it. The holds are interesting. The choice there, the green. It's a little... The hues are a little, to my mind, unbalanced. That blue is very violent compared to the muted everything else, pretty much. But the effects are nice. I wonder if he put in that zipper tone effect at the back.
He would have had to, dude. Yeah, for sure.
I like that. I like the textures and stuff he's using. It's good. I would give that a 6 or 7.
John says, I don't like the orange background against Spidey and Jug's colors.
Yeah, there's a flatness to it, definitely. Contrasting, exactly. Yeah.
I should try and find the original piece.
Like, Spider-Man pops, but then nothing else pops. I suppose, yeah, it does on the rim light on the side of his arm, which is nice. Nice effect.
I think 1.2 is like these rocks, like you only really notice that this one's in front of his leg and these ones are behind, like because of the pencil lines or the ink lines. It's not like the colors are telling you that.
Speaking of artists, we have the Art T Bear in the house. He's calling us orange haters.
Orange is my favorite color.
Is it?
Yeah, I think it's the coolest. Okay, this piece, this is by one of us. What do you think of this, Mike? One of us. Vaughn Coleman.
Me or you?
Vaughn Coleman's book.
I've shown this on the Art Share before. It's great. Now, we did notice there might be a little bit of confusion as to where his wings are, how they're positioned by how they're lit up. I would probably just take all the highlight off him and make him blue, so that he would pop out from that really, you know, orange, ready, demon dragon.
This you're talking about?
Yeah, it makes it a little bit confusing as to how his wings, because they're like rotating or something. So we don't really understand. But other than that, I mean, yeah, I think it's a fantastic piece. I definitely give it like an 8, I guess. It's very art, like it catches it does exactly the job that you want it to do. This has been one of his main promotional pieces for his campaign, and I think it's doing him really well. I think he's over 500 signups or something at this point.
Which is nuts for someone on their first book. That's fantastic.
Yeah, I said to him, dude, that's crazy. And he's like, is it? I don't know. And I was like, yeah, I had like 260 when I launched.
Yeah.
My first book. So, and that was only because I got into Cecil's. I had 60 before then.
This piece makes you want to ask more about like what's going on, what's happening.
Yeah, it definitely, it tells a story. It's like, oh, what the hell happens in this story?
Yeah.
You know, adds a lot of scale to it. So yeah, I think it's really nice. The background and everything.
Well, I'm going to make you choose a winner from all these too, by the way, just because, you know, why not? It's fun. This piece is from Matthew Nickerson. Nickerson. Just get that right.
It's all right. We know you can't do a hard R anyway.
This is Venom and Spider-Man.
If we're just talking colors, they're fine. But, you know, I think 95% of what's going on here is the composition and the actual line art. So,
yeah, like I think it's cool.
You could screw this up in the colors, but he didn't. So, it's fine.
I think like it's cool, but like you don't really notice Spider-Man here until like
I did, yeah. But I would probably try and add in another element, probably with the background.
Yeah,
because his Venom is kind of a blue gray, and then you got the shadows, and then that whatever's in the floor, whatever he's standing on, it looks like a kind of a gargoyle, I guess, is gray, and then you've got a gray background. Maybe it's fine though. I don't know. I just think like the colors are kind of 5% of the equation here. So I would give them a 6.
6. Okay.
They do the job.
Okay. That's
it. I really like that composition. I think that's dope.
That's that pretty much it. This is a painted piece. So I don't know if it really counts. You can rate it if you want, Mike.
Yeah. I don't know. I didn't really know. I mean, I know I know what I likes and I likes what I knows, and that's cool.
All right, so let's go back. You gave this one an 8 or a 9?
9.
9?
But it's still not my favorite. Like, I'm judging it based on its competency in colors. This one I gave a 9 as well, I think.
Yeah.
But I gave a 10.
You gave this a 10?
I think so. But that doesn't mean it's my favorite. I think out of all of them, the one that I most like looking at is probably the one we used on the thumbnail.
This one.
Yeah.
Yeah. What about you, chat? You guys can vote too. Goblin Chick, which is this one. Werewolf Dude or Pirate Chick. There you go. You could even do a poll.
I think the kind of... You want to do a poll?
I mean, you could. I mean, it's up to you.
Get some chat interaction.
Where is the poll, Rob? Says awesome. Dude, I'm doing my job. It's the other person not doing their job.
Colors. We've got... What were they? What were the options?
Wolfman.
Wolfman.
Goblin Queen.
Tits McGee. No,
Goblin Queen.
And
Pirate Chick.
Pirate Chicky.
I mean, then there's the Rob Willis piece and the other piece that you didn't like, but you don't have to put them.
Well, I think those are the top three.
Okay, so, top three. Go with those. Yeah, I think Goblin Queen's gonna run away with it.
No, yeah. Tits McGee is winning. No one's clicking Wolfman.
Yeah, Wolfman's really good, dude.
It's good, but it just there's not. I can't fault it.
Yeah, but it doesn't compared just it just others, doesn't grab you, does it?
Especially compared to Goblin Chick. There's an emotional thing going on there with those reds and blues, and yeah, there's something about it. And plus, as well, it's the art. It's her just, like, staring you right in the face like that.
Yeah, and she's got great boobs. I mean, it's got everything going for it. Like, you'd buy this as a print. Like, if this was available as a print, you'd buy it for sure. It's great. All right, we'll come back to that, Mike. We'll look at the rest. This is just a piece by Joe Bennett, inked by my inker, which is cool. He does a lot of work for everyone. Perfect 10. Mike, you've probably seen this before.
I don't think I have seen that before. So they're bad guys from Perfect 10. I think they are.
I don't know.
Are they the good guys? I can't remember.
Mike, notice how this guy has two mouths?
I did,
This lady has two breasts. Do you think that's coincidental?
This is a problem and a solution. Right.
I know.
There.
Well done. Well done. What do you think?
It's really nice, yeah.
Okay.
Mo says, staring you in the face? What? Oh, she does have eyes. He just noticed that Goblin Tits McGee does have. I do know what I'm talking about sometimes. They are the bad guys from Perfect 10.
This is.
I will get around to reading Perfect 10 at some point. I'm making my way through all the recommendations that are out there. So there's Downcast, Wraith of God, Perfect 10, and then I think some Graham Nolan books.
Yeah.
And then I think I'll have everything covered that people have really consistently recommended to me.
What about Isom?
So what's this that we're looking at?
This is Amiga Red. This is by Felix Icarus Morales. We showed him off 2 weeks ago back on the great stream that I did. What do you think? This is sick, dude. Not a fan?
It's nice. No, it's nice. I feel like there's some and this is coming from me. This is I know how I draw. I feel like there's some like an anatomical proportion problems again, same as there was in the other one. Should his arm be longer, bigger? The shoulder looks, I don't know. There's something, I don't know, you guys. Damn, Bancroft trying to pull out bid this time.
Arm is Thomas too high at the shoulder. Chronicles.
All right, I'll put that into my mental bank. Arm is too high at the shoulder. Yeah, I think that's it. Is it the shoulder? I don't know.
I mean, he could just have his arm up like that,
though. I'm not great at the anatomy as is. So I find it difficult to see it myself, but sometimes you can see it. Yeah, it looks.
Are you guys just saying it because Bancroft said it though? That's what I'm asking. You know,
possibly, but it also it could be a work in progress because it. I don't know. It looks like the forearm and part of the bicep are quite rendered in his face, but then the rest isn't. So, or maybe that's style.
I really dig the face. I think the face looks sick.
Yeah.
But, you know, for all you haters out there, that's fine. This is just Van Orden art. I just thought this was cool. Wolverine.
Cool. Yeah, if you're a big fan of Wolverine, that would be a cool piece to hang on your wall, stuff like
that. Yeah. Like we said, we both love pencils, so.
I like him best in that costume, by the way.
Yeah.
It's a rad costume. Either like that or with it off and a big cigar in his mouth.
Yeah, gotta get the cigar. All right, next piece.
You read
Ulysses Curell.
What is that? Who is that? Looks like I don't Venom, know. But not.
It kind of reminds me of Joe Ball a little bit. I don't know if that is accurate or not, but
No, it doesn't. Joe Ball doesn't draw like that. But I see what you're saying. That's just a lot of detail. Those effects there. Maybe I'm wrong. I just thought this is probably digital. You know those splatters and stuff. I'm gonna guess this is done digitally, but I could be wrong.
I dig this piece, though. I think it's cool.
Yeah, it's very nice. Oh, look. Okay. All right. So is he kind of wearing defeated people's stuff? Because I can see Spider-Man there. That looks like the Thing. He's got a sword. He's got a Venom something. There's the Thor hammer.
Everyone's saying it's Null. Krull? Venomized Null. Guys, sort it out and find out and let us know.
Even
just too many different answers.
Savage Sword of Venom. Yeah, Mo has it. Either way, it's really good.
It's
really
cool.
I love those, you know, heavy blacks.
And you don't see many artists doing like shading or rendering like this, just like straight lines. Like it's usually cross hatching and that kind of stuff, but not in this case.
Oh, I think you do. It's very it's reminiscent of what's his face. I used to do Marcel Buscema. Used to do that a bit. I think people still do that.
I don't see often. Jay Ryan says Bancroft loves the blacks now. Question mark.
When they're appropriate in the composition, yes.
You can rate this piece too, Bancroft, because it is a colored piece. I mean, you've got to give him props for the movement in the boobies.
It's definitely a movement. Yeah, I can tell she is in motion. That's for sure.
She is shaking that thing around.
Being whipped around.
Yeah.
And there's, you know, quite a few little visual clues.
I think this is colored really well. I don't know if you agree, Mike. But I'm looking at everything I need to be focused on. You know, the background doesn't overpower the main image. I think it looks good.
Jiggle physics. Moving apart, says General Meerkat. Yeah, look, Ivan Nunes did very painterly colors in Hunter Ninja Bear, but I think he did them better than this. There are some things, I think it might be too much. Like, see that background, the sky?
That is a lot. I will give you that.
It's just too much, and I think you probably could just not have that, but I like a lot of the holds and
needs edge highlights from General Meerkat.
Yeah, a little bit of, because it is very, I mean, he's going for that dull palette, which is perfectly fine and good. It needs a little bit of pop, but yeah. Assembly Green says dinosaurs, hot women, greater than the sum of their parts.
No. What are you rating this, Mike? What are you rating this? Color wise,
8, I'd say.
Okay, it's pretty good. 8's pretty good. Yeah. Okay, so now we're into the women's section. We have this rogue.
What? Now?
Yes. Yeah.
Every piece is about a woman almost.
I love stuff. So like this is pencils again. Obviously, I love stuff like this. Like this rough pencil look. What you like it or not? It's not enough for you.
This is a little stylized for me. It's a little confused. She has like a tube neck, and I mean the boobs are just two dinner plates.
The orbs.
The orbs on her chest. So, but the face is very nice, and I like the approach to the hair. It's unusual, but it's very realistic. And then the rest is kind of geometric. I guess it's fine if you know you're just doodling.
I think it's cool.
I don't really know the artist, but
it looks like
certainly someone who can draw.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, now that's cool.
Yeah.
Look at the photo on the side
there. I know, I just saw that. this is how Mike likes his women.
No, that's just rad. And that's just cool.
Yeah, that's sick, dude.
What's not to like about that?
That's awesome.
Ew.
What do you think, Art? You like this piece? Look at that tongue. That tongue looks like it does work.
I like how it's, you know, the sinew and the exposed flesh and or whatever that is goes all the way back like a friggin' lizard.
Yeah.
On the head, human's head. That's creepy.
Mo's got a comment for you to read, Mike.
I'm not reading that.
I think this might be one of the best pieces today, but we've got I've saved some of the like the top stuff for last. Okay, so just bear that in mind. Mike, I don't understand what this chick's doing, so maybe you can explain it to me a little bit better. Just give me 1 second here.
She's like going like this, like, you know.
What's she doing though? What is she action? What's that action meant to mean? You know, just for us.
It's just like I'm kind of cool and a bit crazy, and you know, I'm silly. You never know what I'm gonna do next.
Jazz hands.
Yeah, jazz hands. Yeah, exactly.
Guys,
he's doing a minstrel thing.
I'm surprised that's what you went with.
So, don't ever do that again. She got a boob window, but then there's a lightning over it.
Yeah, I mean, that's the takeaway from this image, Mike. All right, moving on.
I think if it was just her from her neck up, I think it'd be a really nice piece. The rest is not working for me.
This is Black Annie by Shaheen Lajoisi.
Is that a top? What is that? What is she wearing? I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like that. I mean, I suppose. The art's very nice. Stylized. It looks like someone who does concept art for computer games and stuff like that, you know?
Oh, it's the same chick from earlier, Mike. Dale says, Black Annie is the pirate girl in the pole.
Ah, there you go. Learning something new every day.
Dojo, you should know this by now. Bancroft, you really don't know your characters. That is a yellow circle behind the lightning bolt, not a boob window.
Well, then why could you see the cleavage just on that part? Go back.
I don't want to prove you're right.
Boob window. If it wasn't a boob window, there would be cleavage all the way down.
All right. Okay. Oh, this piece is sick too, Mike. Let's have a look at this.
Why do I like that when the women are desiccated death creatures more?
Maybe because they won't talk as much.
That broomstick is that's quite disturbing. How's she holding on to that broomstick?
She's using a really strong grip of some sort. She's got a really strong grip.
You know what? I just don't dig tats on chicks, you know. It's just not my thing. So
just you have the weirdest takeaways from things. Like, oh, this piece is ruined. No, she's really tattooed. No,
it's very good. The goat could be a little bit too much with its, I mean, the fur looks great, but it's so detailed compared to everything else, it kind of yanks the eye away, which maybe, but yeah, great. It's really well rendered.
Great piece.
Cool shoes too.
Yep. Shoes are important. That broomstick is expertly inked here, Mike, do you think?
What is?
The broomstick.
Yes, a lot of detail.
Exactly, Mo. He's so infuriating.
Most days her face is right off, but the tats are a real turn off. you gotta draw the line somewhere, Mo.
Dude, she does have really weird boobs. Check out this one.
I don't think she really has them. I mean,
What is that?
She's kind of shrunken, so it actually does fit. Yeah, man has to have standards. Exactly, Simply Green. Otherwise, what are we? We're just beasts.
What's the goat standing on? That's a good question. I think
the goat is on the broomstick.
Yeah. Okay. Next, this is by Tumor Hill. I really like his stuff, dude. I don't know if you've seen his stuff
before. Say that like I know who that is.
Tumor Hill. I think I've got some more pieces of his too.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
It's not really my style, but I can appreciate the artistry. I can see that this is a professional who has honed their craft. Yeah, I can see that part.
Oh, sorry. I didn't realize I was stuck on a part there. What's up, Jasper? Good to see you, dude. Yeah, I really like your stuff, dude. I think it's really nice. Oh, yes.
Oh, I think Corey's already left. He had enough of the flat-chested, desiccated women.
I mean, yeah, I mean, Corey's just killing it at the moment.
I'm going to actually be so interested. Did you realize that you just had your mouse just then?
Yeah.
All right.
Or the...
I'm actually going to be interested in, you know, what this story is going to be. Because he's taking it so seriously. I mean, you put in this level of detail on the art. I mean, this is, and I know how complicated his coloring method is. There's so much that goes into it, but it's a cheesecake story about, you know, these sexy android chicks. But at the same time, it's also, you know, it's like a serious, you know, sci-fi thing that he's doing. So,
I like this thing here. Whatever's going on here, I imagine it's some sort of nipple clamp.
That yeah, it's
one boob to the other one.
It's just holding. It's just like holding on for sheer life, I think.
Yes.
It's just, you know, it's like it's security against a wardrobe malfunction. Hopefully he can get this book ready for Cocktober. It seems like it would be a perfect.
I like how it says police, just because you'd have no way to know otherwise. You know?
Well, I mean, you know, she's in blue and she's got lights and a band-aid.
What do you think about having the same colors here and up?
Calm down, Dojo.
Is that good color work, Mike, having the same blue here and here?
It's Corey's is an excellent colorist, yes.
Okay, that's great, Corey. That's Andromanoids. Sign up for it. I think the link is
yeah, you're not going to want to miss this. I think it's going to be fun. I don't know. It's its own thing. Corey is his own animal, so.
Oh. Art of Roy, who's not here today. Thought I'd show you this piece.
I think we've shown this one off before, but yeah. Art of Roy's rad. He's doing more. He's done another one. He's done a whole bunch. I think Ethan said he's going to actually buy one of his pieces and print it for him.
He should. I mean, he's a great artist.
This is an homage to the great Kelsey Shannon.
His
piece.
That's awkward.
Is it?
What do you think of this piece, Mike? I know I said I was done with the ladies, but apparently not.
I get sad that people spend decades of their life getting this good at painting, and then AI just swoops in. I've got nothing to say about that. You know, that's just like beyond my scope. You know, you need to get Shanth and Jet in here to be able to comment on something.
Variant like cover for Deja Thoris number one. Dude, I mean, like, come on now. That's ridiculous.
Oh, I like that one. I like the expression. I've tried to draw expressions like that, and then I always give up. Because they always look like super ugly when I try it.
You also tried to draw hands.
We should have sent a poet.
That's really nice too, man. Like, that's sick. Yeah.
I even know who that character is too. That's a extra benefit.
Okay. Oh, this one is great. I don't know if you've seen this one before, Mike.
I have seen it. Yeah. I like the knee dick. You see that? That
yeah. I mean, I don't know what's going on here.
That's the best part.
But it's fantastic.
You know, it reminds me, Clark went to a birthday party over the weekend.
This reminds you that Clark went to a birthday party. Okay.
Yeah, because it was at a baking place, and they each made their own cupcakes, and he came home with 9 cupcakes, and he was very particular about who got which.
Mm-hmm.
And he gave me, I think it was a pig cupcake? I can't remember actually. But that's what this reminds me of.
This is from Skunk Artworks. It was a pretty cool piece, but there was one piece here that, hang on, just don't look at these. This piece here.
You can unshare your screen.
Nah, that's fine. I think this is really cool.
Yeah. You know, I have two pieces from Skunk.
Do you?
Yeah.
Two pieces.
He won the Lucent fan art contest. I've got that. And then I've got another one he did of Ella, like more of a sketch. And that's hanging in my living room. Yeah, Skunk is rad. I mean, I was sharing so much Skunk stuff at the start of the art shares. I had to kind of tap the brakes on it.
All right. Well, if you don't want to see any more, it's fine. This is a 17-year-old comic book artist by the name of Andrew Gavaretti. I think this is sick. He's got other stuff too. I'll show in a sec.
Yeah, the cool thing about doing a style like that is it doesn't matter if you have any kind of anatomical issues that we had earlier. Like, it just doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It actually improves it if things are bulging and weird. I think that's really dope.
I mean, that is great as well.
Were you drawing that well when you were 17, Rob?
No, dude, not at all. He had another piece I wanted to show. Anyway, moving on. Sal Regala.
Sounds Italian.
Yeah.
Regala.
What do you think of this? It's good, but it's a bit hard to see, isn't it? Like,
it's definitely one of those things you want colored. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's rad, though. I think it's cool. It makes me interested. It looks a bit like Dimmin is another person that I follow a lot. Art reminiscent of that. Bit cleaner, but
that's a cool panel.
I feel like I've seen this before in pencils. It's very familiar. Yeah, it's cool. I'd be interested in knowing what this is.
Yeah, it's a bit, Jake says it's a bit hard to make out, but it's clearly quality. Yes.
He also says, when I was 17.
This is the piece I wanted to show. This is by the same 17-year-old.
Oh, look, who's that? Now, who's the artist? Is it Otley?
Yep.
Who likes to play with the proportions and stretch things and everything a bit, like, so everyone becomes Mr. Fantastic. Because that's what it looks like what he's doing. I don't know if that's
like half the artists out there, though.
No.
I reckon this is.
I think this guy has a very promising future.
He's 17, dude. Could you imagine drawing this at 17? Not like.
Yeah, sure. I think if I had stuck with it, I could have drawn like that at 17. But
Rick says
I had important things to do. Like, I had to go rollerblade.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great career choice. I think this is one of the better pieces today. I love this style. I don't know if you're going to like it at all, Mike, but I want you to rate the colors on this one, and I want to see if chat likes the style of it too. It's very unique. Here we go. What do you think?
Yeah, I dig it.
I love it. Like, it is just off the wall, bonkers, insane.
And I would 100% read a comic like that.
100%. It just looks sick, dude. I think. You guys like this or not?
Yeah, it's modern. You know, I haven't seen it before, but it's not throwing away what people have learned in the past. It's taking that and doing something new and fresh. So rather than just, okay, well, let's stick with the house style or whatever, let's do something new and fresh. But actually, what really is, it's just like, no, we're just going to be super lazy and do all the art quick, and it's not working. Whereas this is something very different. Yeah, I think everyone's in agreement.
Look at, like, the color on his boot. Like, that is gnarly.
Yeah, I'd be interested to watch this guy work, because that looks like a lot of finicky stuff. Sequential choice is way too busy. Well, you wouldn't. I think if you were to do a comic like this, there would have to be some, like, visual.
Sick, dude.
Look at this shit. Yeah, some moments where you tone it down for the story's sake. If it's all like this, every single page, yeah, I would agree. It would be.
He's done Superman too. I wonder how that's. Oh yeah.
Doesn't really work on Superman for me as much as the others.
Yeah, agreed. Oh, it's a Batman. Yeah, it doesn't work for those kind of things. But
it's interesting.
Yeah, it's. I mean, that the ground looks sick. Like, you imagine she's walking through a pool of blood. It looks great.
It's like goop.
It's cool. I'd love to get a piece like that, but I just don't know what I'd use it for is the problem. Okay, moving on. Gundam. We're into the pros. Hector? Into the pros. Yeah. Hector.
Yeah.
Trunic.
Hector Trunic. So Hector's doing the art for Neff on the new Mavericks book.
What?
Yeah. I said, oh, is this going to be just like a, is this going to be like a 4-page thing? He's like, no, the whole book.
What?
My jaw hit the floor. I can't even imagine what he's paying him, but the stuff is, it looks incredible. It's beyond the pale.
That's going to be incredible, dude. Yeah, I mean, obviously top notch.
Yeah, man. Hector's a beast. I only learned about him through Neff, but I went on a, you know, just went down the rabbit hole, and I was just couldn't believe it.
The like, stuff how crazy off. Is it? Like,
he draws it traditionally. So he paints it traditionally in grayscale, and then he digitally colors it. I think something like that.
He's got.
Oh, so this one is painting. Yeah, well, then there you go. So he probably just do whatever the hell he wants. I think that's what he's doing for Neff. And that's probably, you know, to be able to get things out quickly.
Yeah, I'd like to see more of his stuff. It's great. Netho Diaz, old Spider-Man condition he did, commission he did.
It's pretty cool.
Pretty good. Bit hard to make out all the details. That might just be an uploading issue though. Like, it looks pretty good.
His bottom leg is a little off for me, but everything and the top leg is Todd McFarlane.
Oh yeah, yeah, definitely.
But yeah, no, it's good. It's fine.
All right, now we're getting into the pro.
How many more do we have? Because we're at 15 past the hour.
Like six more. We're into the pros
good.
Now.
We're good. Right, okay, pro, let's go. I'll just piss off.
Like, what can you even say, dude? It's amazing.
Now you're entering friggin' Frank Frazetta levels.
Yeah, you're entering like the genius level of artists now.
This is the kind of stuff that you could imagine could inspire a movie franchise, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's just, it's bonkers.
Hyperwiz is giving you some feedback there. The structure was great today. See what I said? Tell a story.
No, you just insulted me. You didn't give me any feedback. You just said you sucked and do better. This is a cool piece. Not maybe not so pro, but I thought it was good, so I leave it to the end. What do you think of that?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah. Would you say European influenced, Mike?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. You can see it in the way he's drawn, in like on the kind of Möbius style of the rocks that he's standing on, and then just all that detail that isn't really that detailed in the background, which Kenneth Rocafort does that so much, and it's so annoying how good he is at it. See, there's not actually that many lines, but just because it's everywhere, it actually ends up looking super detailed. And
yeah, and the lines aren't necessarily that clean either, but it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, okay. It could be watercolor, got blade. I'm not sure. It could be digital as well. I don't know, but it's friggin' fantastic.
All right, moving on, because I know Bancroft has to get back to, whatever he does. Boris Vallejo.
That's, it's like older sci-fi poster art. Who can do that on the skin? To do that, you have to know the different layers of skin and how the blood shows up in some layers and not in other. Like, Shanth would know all about this stuff.
But this is
just crazy. Wolverine. I feel like these skills could go away.
Yeah.
If people don't pass on the knowledge of how to do this traditionally, it will go away. And people have to relearn it.
That would be a massive shame if that was the case. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful piece. Wolverine by Victor Faro.
Yeah, it's rad. That would be cool in your house.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he had his own trading set in the 90s, says Henry. I'm sorry, guys.
I wonder if that's got impasto and everything on a traditional piece, you know, where the paint sits up.
Yes, it looks like it does for sure. Looks sick. Cool. This is Joe Jusco. I really like this piece too.
It's nice. I'm not as big a fan of it as the others. I think it lacks.
Woman's got boobs.
No, I think it just lacks a little of the sort of perfection compared to the other last ones that you've shown, and a little the atmosphere. I think the background is really well drawn. I mean, obviously, the figures are very well rendered. I couldn't do that. I'm saying that I couldn't do this.
This guy looks a bit creepy, though.
Yeah, a bit stiff.
Looks like he kind of sneaks into like young girls' apartments at night to sniff their panties, Mike.
And his axe is bent. But no, it's obviously I'm nitpicking here. You put it in with all these friggin' great masters, and then, you know, it's like it's a 9 out of 10 instead of an 8, a 10. So,
Witcher's one. This is Gwent from the Witcher card game, which is crazy. Like, sick, dude. How sick is that? That's Bancroft on his throne.
Hang on.
Look at the forehead. It goes all the way up.
No, that's just his hat. That's not me. That's pretty cool. Gross, though.
Cool piece, though, yeah?
Super creepy. Ugh. Yeah, it's like that. See what I'm saying about atmosphere? There's just, like, you feel like... See, with this piece, you feel like you're there. And there's a real story going on. With that other piece... I felt like I was looking at a drawing, you know?
Yeah, like imagine you're thrown into the world. You walk around a corner and you come across this. That's kind of how
I'm walking around any corners out there. I think I'm already in the thick of it. But yeah, I take your point.
Yeah, you take my point. I'm pretty sure Sumo Thori wanted me to share this. It could be someone else. I'm pretty bad with remembering who shared stuff with me. Pretty good, man.
Who's the artist?
Jay Ancelot. Jay Ancelot. I don't know. Pretty good. Pretty damn good.
Yeah, it's all right. I like that one. I like that one.
Dude, come on.
No, well, let's just look. It's fine.
Wow. You sure know how to make...
Put it in the master's section.
You sure know how to make a man feel appreciated, Sumo Thori, who gave you 5 memberships at the start
of the
show.
I really like that one.
This is Ken Kelly, The Observer. Everyone's been bugging Bancroft because I didn't put it in 2 weeks ago, apparently.
Yeah, well, you gave me as a thumbnail, and then we didn't actually show it off. I thought it was fitting.
It's a great piece. It's got those
back melons.
She does have the back melons. I think anytime that you can have one color and make it so different and diverse is very impressive.
Yeah. It's almost Frazetta-ish.
It is beautiful. There's one piece, I don't know where it's gone, that I really wanted to show.
Can you say the name again? Cranberry Langers didn't catch it.
The name for this is Ken Kelly from The Observer, 1992. Ken Kelly. That's it, Mike. I'm gonna look for the piece. I don't know where it's gone though. Actually, maybe if you just go to my saved ones. Just give me a second. How did the poll go, Mike?
It was pretty conclusive. So the Wolfman won at 9%. Are we doing it the most votes? Obviously Tits McGee. At 72%, Goblin Chick, clearly.
This might be my favorite piece of the day, and it might only be me that feels this way, so I'm prepared to take the criticism if that's the case, but I just thought this was sick. This is from Anton Marx.
Opening it up.
It has that real Mike Butkus kind of feel. What do you think of this, Mike? I think it's sick.
No, it's not my favorite. I appreciate it. It's clearly very well rendered. I feel like it might just... This to me falls into the camp of hyper-realism, which is, you know, I think you'd lose a little bit of the... You know? It's good, though. It's very good. I couldn't do it. So I don't feel I should critique it, but I think some of the others you shared were proper masterpieces.
What's your favorite of the day?
I like Tits McGee. I liked pretty much most of the things you shared at the end.
Yeah.
It could be Uncanny Valley. I'm not sure.
Woo-hoo.
You shared so many things, I can't remember them all now. But...
I know. You.
She's the winner. She's the winner of the best colors competition, and she'll be receiving her prize shortly, which is nothing. It's the hyperism that really bothers me. You know, one of those... What, a pretty young lady? Is that what you're talking about? I don't know, Mo. I can't even imagine what you're talking about. Do you have anything you want to announce, Rob?
We're going to be doing Replicator. It's going to launch in June. So Replicator 4 is going to launch in June. Yeah, we're going to do it. It gives me, 3 months to build up from now. So, yeah.
Get the hype train going.
Yeah, exactly. I'll start sharing some stuff. We've got so much of it done. I talked to Mike about it. Like, there's a lot of spoiler stuff that you'll see, but the pages that I have, they're just too good. I have to show them off. So get ready for it. It'll be coming soon.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking as well. Just show them.
Yeah.
I think the Slumlord's alive. I think. So I'm going to send you all over there. Don't know what they're talking about, if it's of any interest to any of you, but, you know, better than just letting you dissipate into the ether.
Blame Mike, Simo. He gave me the hurry up, so I couldn't really give the guy any due. So Mike's fault, clearly.
No, he put it in the wrong section, Simo. If you had to put it earlier, I would have been gushing over it. And he did kind of just flick through it, so I didn't really get it. Very, very talented, obviously, clearly.
Cheers, Hyper. Appreciate that.
But yes, excellent. And I will be sending out an update over the next couple of days as to where I'm at with the book. Getting a lot done. Jumping onto some new things. So, yeah, look forward to that. It's getting very close. I'm feeling pretty confident with where it's at now. So, yeah, look forward to an update coming into your emails if you have backed or signed up. Otherwise, it'll just appear on the website. Bancroft, please never say gushing again. That's a request from him. No promises. I mean, I just read it, so no promises.
Cheers, Jake. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Yeah. I love this stuff, man. I love this stuff.
I think that was a Thanks, successful Mo. Art share.
It was good. Yeah, it was good.
Well, we got a Rumble rant from Fopizi over there on Rumble. He says, "Do you think some of the hyper-rendered things that look great are going to eventually remind everyone of AI art? Some of these look great, but kind of think of AI." I think that's already happening. That's what I was saying. Sure. I feel bad about these amazing artists who've spent decades becoming the best in the world at what they do. And now whenever they post it, everyone just says that's AI. And
Was it you that was saying, though, that that's going to make like the people that do traditional stuff, like their stuff, even more valuable, though?
Well, I think everyone's saying that, yeah, it's going to be more sought after and it's going to be more about the actual creation of the pieces rather than necessarily the end product is going to become more important, I think. So, yeah, look at that stuff. Pretty cool. All right, I do have to get back to work. Thank you, Rob. Hail to the chat. Thank you so much, everyone, for sticking with us. This is really cool. We can still
You guys are the real G's.
You are. You really are. We got, you know, over 50 people in here between Rumble and YouTube for the whole hour and a bit. So thank you so much. To send your art share suggestions, do you just hashtag art share? Yes, I do go through that. Also, and you tag me as well. That's probably even better.
It's Bancroft's
no guarantee that I'll show them, but.
Bancroft's turn next week, guys. Sorry.
But you'll be here to criticize what I show.
Of course, yes.
All right, good.
Won't be as good as mine.
Well, clearly.
Catch you guys.
Have a good night. Bye.